Hey, you wandered into the best Peter Pan game retrospective you've ever seen. And by best, I mean only. Hope you enjoy. So, our story begins. Psh, what am I talking about? What story? The only thing you do is look for treasure and rescue some of your homies. But for real, Captain Hook finds a treasure map to the island of Neverland, which should contain gold and jewels and... Wait, what the hell does he need with treasure? He lives on a deserted island. Money literally means nothing to him. It should be useless. Anyway, he memorizes where the treasure is located, and he tears apart the map so that Peter Pan won't be able to stop him. Cause, you know, it'd be like that sometimes. Meanwhile, Peter's just pacing back and forth in his hideout, like a kid who just drank his first Red Bull. And Peter walks up to Tinky and says, "Hey, why does this place look more empty than a store after Black Friday? Where everybody at?" And Tinky's like, "I don't know, bro. I don't know where the hell they at." And Peter's like, "So what you trying to do today?" And Tinky's like, "You trying to find some treasure?" And Peter's like, "Yeah, alright. I'm down." So the first level begins, and the only thing Peter can do is walk and, you know, fly, because, you know, that's his main thing. Except for the fact that he's also immortal.
There can be only one.
So eventually Peter does find his knife.
That's not a knife. That's a knife.
In the middle of some woods for some reason. And the first task is to kill a bird. Why? Because fuck birds. So after getting his knife back, Peter decides to talk to some mermaids. Or should I say, mermaids.
Hi, Peter.
Hi, Peter. Did you miss me?
Hi.
So the mermaids tell Peter that they saw something flying in the sky, so that's where we're going. And after some more nonsense, we actually find a piece of the treasure map. But then we hear some evil laughter. And Peter senses that something's wrong with his mermaids. And they is in trouble. We gotta go save they ass. So Peter flies over and sees a pirate threatening the mermaids. And we ain't having none of that shit.
It's time for a death battle!
So Peter thinks that this is gonna be an easy battle, but the pirate has an ability called Infinite Knives. But after Peter dodges all the knives and stabs the pirate in the face, he manages to rescue the mer-babes. Oh yeah. So after stabbing the pirate in the face, Peter decides to turn his knife into a boomerang. How he does this is, actually I have no idea. He wills it into existence, I guess, I don't know. But at least it does let us kill some more birds. So Peter thinks that this is the perfect time to go search for his homies, cause why the hell not, I don't know. So after traveling through the forest, running away from some mosquitoes, cause not even Peter Pan wants to deal with that shit. We don't deal with no damn bugs around here. And then, you know, killing some more birds. We meet up with the two Siamese cats from Lady and the Tramp. Who say that they found another piece of the treasure map by the ship. So, that's where we're going. So after retrieving the piece of the map, the two Siamese cats appear and they say that the pirates have kidnapped the rest of Peter's homies. And that they saw some pirates go into this big ass rock with a skull face. But it turns out that we can't travel further inside because there's a big-ass rock blocking our way. So Peter turns to Tinkerbell and says, "Hey, yo, Tink, you got some of that cocaine dust? You know, the one that lets us fly high in the sky." And then Tink says, "Oh, yeah, I had a whole bag in the forest. Let's go get some." So Peter and Tink go off to find their drugs, but along the way, they find that a fat Turkish pirate has already found their stash. So you know what that means.
It's time for a death battle!
So this pirate's whole gimmick is that he throws his big-ass sword, which disobeys all the laws of physics, and then he sprays some, you know, cocaine dust on some barrels, which makes them fly high in the sky. So naturally, you throw your knife at the barrels, and they explode right in the pirate's face. Wait, what the hell is in those barrels? What the hell is my knife made out of? Why the crap is everything exploding? Questions for later. So it's time to go back to the cave, you know, with the one with the scary ass face. And we gotta remove, you know, the rock that was blocking our way. But along the way, we found one of our homeboys.
"Hello, baby. I am the locksmith of love."
Pepe Le Pew. So Peter asks him, "Hey, yo, man, what you doing in this cave?" "Man, I was out here cruising for chicks, and then next thing I know, I'm stuck in a cage in this nasty-ass cave." "Well, look, I'm gonna meet you back at the hideout. Peace out, man." Following that, Peter flies towards the rock, and then he sprinkles some cocaine dust on it, and it flies so high in the sky that it crashes down and dies. So Peter and Tink travel through the dank-ass cave and come upon a ghost with a bomb strapped to it. So, you know, we ain't deal with that shit. You know, there's two things that we don't mess with, and those are ghosts and bombs. So we out this bitch. Peter manages to escape, but Mr. Smee, who has been wandering around this creepy ass cave for some reason, and yeah, you know, the ghost is like, "Hey, yo, boo," and then explodes right in his face, which sends Smee flying high in the sky. So naturally, Peter follows Smee and finds him straddling a rock. The hell was he doing? Anyways, Peter straight up pulls out his knife and threatens to stab Mr. Smee. My boy, straight savage. "Where my homies at, Mr. Smee? Tell me, or I'ma gut your ass." And Smee is like, "Hey man, I don't know nothing about that, but if you're looking for treasure, there's a piece of the map float up high in the sky, right by the ship." "All right then, be cool, Mr. Smee. Peace." So Peter manages to find the third piece of the map, but is stumped as to where the last piece could be. You know, since the last three were by the ship, it would dictate that it's next to the damn ship, but Peter's too stupid to understand that. Anyway, he decides to go and ask the Indian chief. Whilst trying to get to the village, Peter runs into an invisible wall, which puzzles him because what in the actual hell? So he finds Tiger Lily and says, "Hey, I was flying straight, and then this invisible wall just came out of nowhere. Do you know what's going on?" And she's just like, "Yeah, have you tried playing music?" "What?" "Sometimes if you play music, invisible things appear." "Yeah, okay." And then Peter's like, "Damn it, I probably shouldn't have fed the crocodile my panpipes. But to be fair, I was flying high in the sky off my cocaine dust." Peter manages to find the crocodile in the big ass rock with the scary face. And to make his life easier, Pan sprinkles some cocaine dust on the crocodile and then stabs it until the crocodile throws up his backpipes. Backpipes, panpipes, whatever the thing is. So Peter goes past the invisible wall and reaches the village because the power of music, I guess. I don't know. I'm as confused as you are. So Peter goes up to the chief and says, "Hey, man, I'm trying to find this treasure. Have you seen it?" And the chief is like, "Nah, man, I'm sorry, bro. I don't know what that is. But you can go talk to the lake. It'll tell you where it is." And then Peter's like, "Yeah, okay. Thanks. Peace out. Bye." At this point, Peter decides that it's time to go and rescue his homies. He already found Pepe Le Pew up in the dank cave, so we ain't gotta worry about that. The next one on the list is Roger Rabbit.
"I wasn't worried for you."
And this man ain't even lost. He's just chilling in the forest. The third one is Baloo, you know, from the Jungle Book.
"Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities."
But for some reason, he's chilling by the beach. Peter's like, "Hey man, what you doing here?" "None your damn business, man. Can't a man just chill, have a vacation? Damn." "But I thought the pirates captured you." "I'm a grown ass bear. The hell kind of pirate you think gonna capture my ass?" "You're right, you're right. You deserve a vacation. Okay, bye." And the final guy is Robin Hood.
"Sweet perfume."
"Hey, whoa, it's fighting over. You're burning the chow."
Who's just chilling in the forest, and when you see him, he's like, "Verily, verily, verily, something, something, verily, verily." So Peter's like, "Yeah, okay, man, I'm gonna see you back at the hideout, all right? Peace."
"No more drugs for that man."
So we rescued all of our homies, so, you know, we good. But while flying by, Peter notices like some teepee just chilling out, you know, in the middle of nowhere. And he's like curious. He's like, "I'm gonna go see what's up with that." So he goes down, right? And he sees like this man, and the man's just like, "Hey, yo, what you doing up here?" And Peter's like, "I'm just trying to check this out. I've never seen you before. What's going on?" And the man is just like, "Hey, yo, I'm a dealer. Yo, I can sell you some things. What you trying to get?" And Peter's just like, "Yo, dope. I mean, like, what you want for currency?" And the man's just like, "I want feathers." And Peter's like, "Why?" And then the man's just like, "None of your damn business." And then Peter's like, all right, man, chill. I got feathers. I got feathers for days." So the man's just like, "Hey, yo, come inside. See what I got. I got some lives. I got some cocaine dust. Oh, we could just chill and watch a movie. What you trying to get?" So, you know, after dealing with our dealer, Peter decides that it's time to go and look for the lake so we can find the treasure. And it's back with the dank ass cave, you know, with a scary face. So, you know, Peter gets there and then he's just like, "Hey, lake, you trying to help me out?" And the lake is just like, "Hey, yo, dumbass, where'd you find the rest of the pieces of the map? Next to the ship. Maybe go back and look." And Peter's like, "Damn, you right." So that's where we going. So, you know, eventually you do find all the pieces of the map. But then, yo, Shadow just springs up out of nowhere. And he's just like, "Hey, yo, this is mine now." And just like zooms his ass away. So Peter's just like, "What in the hell? Man, having none of that." So, you know, you chase his shadow and, you know, you catch his ass because it's a shadow. I mean, I am like confuddled as to why his shadow could just come alive whenever it wants and just leave. I am beyond confused. But Peter finally has all of his pieces because, you know, he just like put his shadow back in his place. Figure that shit out. Anyway, so he sees it, right? But then he sees that Captain Hook and Smee have found the treasure before him. Oh yeah, this whole time Smee and Captain Hook have been looking for the treasure, but because they're dumbasses, it took them like, I don't know, like the whole ass day to find it.
8, 4, 9, 50. "Mr. Smee, are we walking in circles?"
Why do you say that, Captain?
"This skeleton, you blithering idiot!"
Because they're stupid, I don't know what to say. Well, anyway, so they stole the treasure, and Peter's like, man, I've been looking for this crap all day. And now they have it. Man, have another of that. So, you know, he follows them back to the ship. And, you know, but before that, we gotta go talk to our dealer one more time. And the dealer's just like, what you trying to have? All right, now that we've got everything we need, we go and confront Captain Hook. And Captain Hook is just like, hey, yo, it's mine, man. I found it fair and square. Get your ass out of here. And Peter's just like, nah. So you know what time it is.
It's time for a death battle!
So, I mean, you fight Captain Hook, right? And the man is like fast as hell. This man be jumping, flipping all over the place. He's like a Jedi on cocaine. So, you know, after he does that, Smee just like rolls out and starts shooting cannons at your face. But then Peter deflects the cannonball into Captain Hook. You physics be damned at this point. You know, I don't even know what to say. You know, Peter's immortal. We live in a magical island. People be flying. Physics don't matter. So Captain Hook just, you know, gets hit in the face with a cannonball and falls into the water. And then there's a freaking crocodile down there. So he's just like, oh, hell nah, and runs on the water like he's Naruto, right? And then I don't know. People be running on water now. I am confused out of my mind. So, you know, we finally found the treasure. So, you know, Peter goes up. He's all proud. He's just like, man, I found this treasure. I rescued all my homies. I deserve this. And so he opens up the treasure, and the only thing in there is a golden feather. The hell we have fun to do with the golden feather? No, but you know, if I'm being real, this game is really fun. You know, especially if you're into old school platforming, that sort of thing. This game's really fun, especially if you're a fan of, you know, the cartoon, you know, the one from 1950, whatever. And, you know, I would do recommend that you play it because it really is fun, you know, all joking aside. But, yeah, thank you for everybody who made it. Thanks, Disney, and hopefully you don't demonetize me. And thank you guys for watching. Peace out.